New tonight, a local push to keep houses of worship safe during the holidays. Of course, many of you are spending more time in churches and in synagogues.
A North Las Vegas man is teaching worshipers how to protect themselves. This following a string of attacks, including the synagogue shooting in Pittsburgh.
And 13 Action News anchor Mahsa Saeidi is near Bonanza and Eastern with a one-of-a-kind program.
This is what CRI looks like on the inside. It's a renowned counterterrorism training school where they teach worshipers how to survive during an active shooting. You learn everything from self-defense to training with an airsoft gun. And this right here is a simulated gunfight.
One, two!
A group of men preparing for the worst case scenario.
You agree that the first shot is so crucial?
Their coach tonight is Doron Benbenisti, the founder of Crisis Response International, a school that has been in the Valley for more than a decade. But now for the first time, his students are congregants.
They are like sheep to the slaughter if they do not take action to protect themselves.
Sheep to the slaughter, that's a pretty strong phrase.
Yes.
His alarm and concern is understandable considering the recent mass shootings at houses of worship, the latest a Pittsburgh synagogue. 11 killed.
It hit home. It hit home even more so because it was a Jewish synagogue.
And like so many other synagogues in the country, Rosalind Gillis says her congregation started asking questions.
What happens if the back door's breached? How about the upstairs?
Tonight, they have an emergency safety plan in place, a coordinated strategy that includes disarming a shooter.
Down, back.
Rosalind quickly learned this maneuver, and she has practiced it over and over again.
Get down on your knees.
Role-playing and training that Rosalind says has made her feel empowered. She's even in the process of getting her own weapon.
I have a husband, he has a gun, but I'm not with my husband 24/7.
Benbenisi says anyone can learn these potentially life-saving skills at a time when houses of worship are constantly under threat. Mahsa Saeidi, 13 Action News.